So I made this video a couple of days after my dear sweet little lady got hit by a car and died. It was December 22nd, so I made it around the 24th or so in her memory. But I decided to record another one because there's been some updates with the other dog, Buddy. So these are these two stray dogs that just came around my yard probably in September. Around that time, and tell you the story. So Buddy, which is the dog I call, he's black and white, and he's a really shy dog. He never let me touch him till recently, which I'll get into. And he came around the yard one day, and I kind of walked out there kind of shocked. I'm like, oh, is this dog here? And he kind of just sat there. And my first instinct was to kind of shoo him away. But I'm like, you know, I see dogs as like someone's kid. You know, I'm like, I don't know whose dog this is. So I kind of let him be. And then I had noticed him the next day and the next day. It was probably like two or three times. And I'm like, well, this dog's, you know, obviously a stray. You know, because I had seen dogs around here before. But usually they'll be around one or two times, then you never see them again. So when you see them a little consistent, you know, it's kind of obvious. And so I remember the first time I saw him, I was making brisket, and I started giving him some scraps out there. And then about a couple of times later, Lady showed up with him, and I guess they had bonded together because they were always together after that. So I gave them both kind of scraps, and I started doing it regularly after that. It was almost basically like an everyday thing. Anything I had in there that I can feed them, I was giving them. I was getting them some, you know, ham or some weenies and things like that. And another time it was like, you know, pretty hot. Now, you know, I don't know why I didn't snap right away, but I'm like, how are these dogs drinking? You know, what are they drinking in this weather? It's so hot. How do they survive out here? So I started giving them water. I put a little kind of a container with water out there. And of course they, you know, stayed around all the time after that. And I let them be. I didn't try to, you know, take them in. Just because I have four dogs already, and I thought any more would be excessive, but I was kind of worried about them because I don't want them to get picked up, because I've seen where, you know, dogs are taken when they're strays, and it's like not a nice place to be if you've ever gone there. And you know, you think and you see what these dogs have to live through day after day. It's just not a good place to be at, all the barking and all that stuff. So after a while, maybe after a month, I started feeding them, you know, regular dog food. I'm like, well, I should start, you know, if they're going to, because I just thought they would be around for a week or two. Because I've seen some dogs that have done that around here where they've hung out for a little while and then someone picks them up or their owners come for them. And I thought that was the case, but no. So Lady let me touch her right away, let me pet her. And I noticed that she had just had babies like a while back. So I was all like, oh, you know, I was kind of upset because I'm like, this poor puppy, you know, whatever, she's probably like at least a year old, you know, had dogs, her owners, you know, probably, you know, just got rid of her and kept the puppies or whatever the case was. And Lady was the sweetest dog I had ever had. She was really sweet. You know, she would growl at Buddy whenever they were eating, but that's the only time I saw her aggressive. She was really nice and let me touch her and, you know, pick her up. And it started getting cold. So I was really worried about them. So I left them out a blanket for them to lay on, and they were right by the door. And because it's warm by my door, the air doesn't flow through there. You know, the wind, I mean, like real, real hardcore. And so they did that for a while. That was in November because it started getting cold here in November. And I didn't even realize it till I was sitting here doing the math. I'm like, wow, they've been here already for 3 or 4 months. And when December rolled around, it was really cold. So I'm like, well, I need to get these dogs inside, you know, even if it's just the garage. And Buddy wouldn't do it. but Lady let me pick her up. So I put her in my spare room. And she was hanging out in my spare room for about 2 or 3 weeks, almost all day for the most part. I would just let her out before I would go to work. and in the morning to eat with a buddy, because I kind of felt bad just to kind of keep her away from him, and she wasn't kind of integrated with my dogs yet. So I mean, I know she was lonely, I know he was lonely, so I would let her out for a little bit, and they were fine. And I was always worried about them getting hit by a car, because I would see them walk, because I'm right here by an access road by the highway. And I would see them get close there, and it would like really give me anxiety. I'm like, oh no, these dogs are gonna get hit, man. Like every time I would drive home, I would just kind of like pray, because I don't leave the house too much because I work from home, but I would just pray that when I'm coming back from somewhere, I didn't see them in the road, because it was just, dead somewhere, because it was something that was always on my mind for them. I worried about them. And so she was in the house for a good 3 weeks, and me and her, I really fell in love with that dog. She was my baby. She was so lovable, and she would do this thing when I would walk in, like wake her up, I'd open the door, and she would just kind of like shake back and forth, like still laying down, but like move around all excited. Instead of like barking or jumping around, she would just kind of like roll around. And I thought it was real cute, because none of my other dogs do that. I mean, Cuda, she gets excited when I see her, and the other ones kind of do, but they don't do something like that. So she had a distinct way of being happy. And unfortunately, that ended on the night of December 22nd, 2017. I got up for work, and I did my usual routine. I had to let her out through the window, because I don't want to take her to the front door because my dogs go crazy. But that would be the last time I had seen her. I put her down outside the window, and always put her real slowly and gently, so her feet would touch. And she would do the same thing all the time. She would see Buddy at the end of the house, because there's like an alleyway from my window to the front yard, and she would just run full speed to greet him, because I know they both, they live for each other. They bond together. They've been strays together for who knows how long, till they found me here. And like I said, I feel so bad for letting her out, but that was my reasoning for it. And so about an hour and a half later, I go out to call her in, because I'm gonna start working, so, and it's cold, so I want her to be inside. And I can't find her. I'm calling her for a few times, and she was usually always with Buddy, and I thought it was weird. But there had been a few times where she had gone on other streets, and she'd ran home. But I looked for her for a good, 3 or 4 minutes, calling her, nothing. So I thought, oh well, maybe she's on another street. Maybe someone else is taking care of her. That's my first thoughts. And throughout the night, I work right by my window in the front yard, and I didn't see her, passing by or going through the yard like they usually do. And I thought that was kind of strange. And I had even seen someone kind of go underneath my truck, but it happened to be a cat early in the morning. So again, early in the morning that same day, of course, or the next day, because it was the 22nd going into the 23rd, I go out to feed Buddy and her, calling her again. I can't find her. I can't see her. I'm looking around. I walk down the street, whistle for her, and I'm like, wow, that's really strange. Maybe she's farther than she usually goes. That's what I'm hoping. And I end up going to the store, and then on my way back, driving down my street, my headlights show me her, her outline of her body underneath the vehicle of the neighbor across the street. And my first thing is, first thoughts are like, well, hopefully she's just laying down, she's just sleeping. But right away I'm like, no, she's, because I can see Buddy across from her, dancing around, because he can see my truck, so he's excited for me, returning home. And I'm just kind of like heartbroken, man. I'm like, no, please don't be her. And I park my vehicle, and I get out, and I go look underneath the vehicle, and I see her face, and I see, some blood coming out of her mouth that were, dried up now. And I'm just thinking, like, oh my God, she had got hit last night, right when I had let her out around that time. So it really upset me. To me, it looked like, because the way the vehicle parked, and I see those neighbors, how they park just, right in front of their house on the site there. So the vehicle's coming down the street, she's playing or chasing it, and then she's like trying to get off the street, on the side there, and she probably just got hit as they were parking. And I'm sure it wasn't a high impact, but of course hard enough to kill a small dog. And so I waited till the light to come back on, because it was, still early in the morning, like six, it was close to seven. But I wanted to wait, I don't want to be underneath a neighbor's car or anybody's car, and get shot. So I kind of waited till the light to come on, and I walked out there and I had to pull her out from a shovel because she was like perfectly in the middle of the vehicle. I got her out and I carried her to my front yard, and I still had to work for a while, so I was just there kind of looking at her, just thinking how upset I was just because of about 2 days before I had just bought her a new bowl, but her and buddy a new bowl, and I was gonna go back and get them some stuff for Christmas. And yeah, it was you know, upsetting for me. I buried her in my front yard. I everything was gonna be closed for the holidays. I had thought about cremating her, but it was already Saturday, and I mean, nothing was gonna be open till Tuesday, and it was hard to see her, and I kind of didn't want her just laying around anywhere and things like that. So I buried her, and you know, I miss her a lot. She was a really good dog, and I had so much plans for her that it sucked to see her go like that, you know. And I felt like I failed her just because I had let her out, you know, because I wanted Buddy and her to have some fun, and now, you know, she's dead and Buddy's still lonely. But Buddy now, the only bright side, there's no real bright side of her passing away, but you know, Buddy, when I had made this video, you know, I felt really bad because he was out there lonely. Well, it's been even more cold, and last night for New Year's Eve, he finally came inside. He finally came inside, and he went straight to the same room she went to, and I put him in there, and he stayed there the whole night because it was been, you know, 20-something degrees. And, you know, it's freaking cold for him to come inside, and he let me pet him, and he was real scared. He was shaking and at first, and then he started letting me pet him more, and now he's been in there for a day and a half or so because it's still cold. And I don't think I want to let him out, you know. I don't think I want to let him out because I can't let that same stuff happen to him that happened to her. And, you know, when I had made the other video, when I talked about this, you know, I kind of felt like, well, it felt so strange to take care of him without her, because they were like the duo. They were like my two outside dogs that I would have loved to have taken inside, but again, they didn't want to come. Well, one of them didn't want to come inside, and you know, one of them, you know, she wasn't going to get along with my dogs yet. They were still trying to get it going, so it makes me upset that I couldn't get that taken care of. So now I'm kind of real, you know, focused on getting Buddy to get along with my dogs, because I don't want to see them just kind of get thrown out there, you know. And you know, mistakes happen, you know, for people that drive out there and animals, you know. I get calls all the time about stuff like that. But so anyway, he's been inside. I'm gonna try and get him to get used to hanging out with me first, you know, because he's a real scared dog. But he gets along with dogs. He had got a real bad cut on his leg actually a while back, and I felt so bad. I wanted to help him out, but he wouldn't let me touch him. I wanted to give him some ointment for it, maybe wrap it up, but it's just, he wouldn't let me. But it's healed. He's gotten better. It's just because he doesn't let, you know, because he doesn't fight other dogs, so he lets the dogs run over him, you know, really. So now I'm gonna take care of him. Basically, he's adopted now. He's spoken for, and I even started laughing to myself the other day because I went out there, and I got scared for a moment because he's always at my front door, always. And I went out there, and he wasn't there, and I'm like, Buddy. And then there's the guy across the street. He looks at me, and I'm like, oh. And, I whistled first, actually. I whistled first, and he turned, but I didn't see him. And then I said, Buddy. And he looked at him like, oh, no, I'm sorry. I'm, you know, asking for my dog. And he's like, oh, there he is. And Buddy was running across the street to me. And I thought it was funny that I said my dog, you know, because I always kind of seen them as my dog, but they've been strays. But for me to say it, you know, kind of nonchalantly, just automatically, you know, my dog. So I was like, well, I know I need to take care of Buddy. So he's in the house now. I'm going to, you know, really do my best to get all the dogs to get along. It's not the first time I've introduced dogs to each other. You know, I had introduced Rin to Brownie before he passed away. And I had introduced Kuda to both of them. And then I introduced, you know, Hinata to all three of them. And Kuda's crazy, so I'm surprised she got along with Hinata. And then I introduced, you know, Guts, the most recent addition, adoption, to all of them. And they were all going crazy too, and they met Guts. He was in his cage. I let them kind of chill out for a day. So what I'm probably going to do, those of you who have never done this for dogs, you know, kind of introduced them to each other, is put the new dog in the cage and let the other dogs kind of smell him, hang around with them for a good day, get used to him, them being around, let the other dogs get used to being around for about a day or two, and then slowly, you know, have the other dogs kind of hang out with them outside the cage. Like for me, I'm probably going to have just Rin and Guts hang out with him while he's loose, and then, you know, kind of go from there. Kuda would be the last one because she's the boss of the gang. She tries to roll everyone. So that's what's going on with that. Some of my memories of Lady, and I have to do this because I'll forget. I have the worst memory in the world. Is seeing her run super fast. That dog ran so fast. I went out one day and I was gonna go out there and feed her or something, and she had like chicken bones, and I was trying to get it away from her because, you know, I don't want her to die from eating chicken bones and shit or choke on it. She was like about a good 100 feet down the street, and I was whistling for her, and I saw her running with the chicken bone in her mouth, and she's just there and, you know, playing around in the front. And actually, I just gotten wings that day, I remember, and I thought it was funny. I'm like, you don't need to eat, you know, eat that. I'm feeding you, you know. I'm like, where are you getting this shit from, you know? And I didn't like her doing that because, you know, some people are assholes and they'll poison dogs and shit like that. Give them food that's got crap in there. And but that's one of my favorite memories of hers running down the street so fast like that. I used to go out during the day, you know, and make some time for them. I would open the garage and have a cigarette and just spend time with her because I knew no one else was spending time with her, you know. And Buddy wouldn't let me do anything, so it was just me and her. He would kind of like stay kind of far away from me. But yeah, she'll be missed. I wished that he would have came in sooner, you know, with her, so they could have I could have kept them just together, and you know, things could have been different. But you know, I can't do anything now. I do feel horrible about it, but you know, I'm gonna try my best with Buddy here, and hopefully he's the fifth addition here to the NWO. So hopefully 2018 brings better luck for everyone. I lost Brownie and I lost her. Shittier. I never did a video on Brownie just because I was so upset for probably 2 months. So I'll probably end up doing a video on him soon. Maybe on his anniversary, maybe a little bit before. But yeah, with him, I mean, of course I'll get into more detail, but you know, he was all I thought about for a good 2 weeks. You know, literally I would think about him all the time, and I still think about him every day, you know. I still miss him, but it was rough those first 2 or 3 weeks, and even 2 months. It was just like, wow, you know, because he had been with me through everything, like I said. But I'll tell the Brownie story. I'll tell the Brownie story soon. The way I came up with their names was kind of funny. When I would see Buddy, I would always say, "Hey, Buddy," you know. I would always just call him that, like, you know, Buddy. And it became a habit because I wanted to, you know, he was my buddy, my pal, my bud. And when I saw a lady, I would always call her, you know, Mamas. And I had initially named them Mia and Yuli from the Ronin Warriors, but I didn't want to name her Mia just for a couple of reasons. One is because there's a porn star named Mia, so I didn't want her to be named after a porn star. Or when I said it, think of the porn star, you know, name. So I had just started calling her, you know, Mamas for a while, and then I always called her Crazy Lady because she was always crazy, always excited. So I, Crazy Lady, you know, and then it was just Lady, and I thought that was perfect for her because she was real ladylike. She had a real perfect, pretty face and look to her. And then Buddy, I would always call him, "Hey, Buddy," you know, and not thinking of thinking about trying to give him a good name, you know, but I couldn't think of a good name to fit him. And then someone that was with me, they go, "He looks like a buddy," and I'm like, "Yeah, well, I guess that is gonna be his name. I've been calling him that for like 3 months now." I'm like, "Hey, buddy," every time I would see him. So that's how they got their names. And he's perfect for Buddy because he's so, you know, he's so shy, and she was so, like I said, ladylike. She was so like a lady dog. She was just perfect. I loved her, and him too. I worry for him, you know. And even though I couldn't take care of him, you know, I would always think about him. Like, but that's why I would let Lady outside to kind of spend time with him. So, two good dogs. I guess my whole point of making this video is if you're able to take care of a dog, you know, definitely do your best. Because the reason, and people ask me, like, what do you care about a dog? What do you do about that? You know, it's like dogs. It's And it really made me think about it when Lady died too. And when she died, I took it upon myself to get her, take care of her, and bury her and miss her, because no one else is going to miss her. The people that, the assholes that just let her go and didn't look for her or whatever the case was, didn't care about her enough to take care of her, weren't worried about what could happen to her. And now that she's gone, I'm sure that no one else but me and me alone think about her and try and, cherish her memory and spread her memory with everyone, share her memory. And I think that's a great thing, because when we all die, who's going to remember us but our family and our loved ones? And a lot of these dogs, tons of animals, but dogs are my thing. They die and that's it for them, Who's going to remember this dog from here or there or whatever, down the street? So I feel real bad for dogs, because they can't tell you what's wrong or what's happened in their life. Like, obviously with Buddy, he's really shy and he doesn't let anyone touch him. And I'm pretty sure someone was really mean to him for him to be like that, because I've seen animals that, yeah, they're not integrated with people, so they don't let you touch them, but he's got a fear of people. I feel bad for him that he's like that, So no one cares about him. He's afraid of people, and when he dies, no one's gonna care, right? So that's part of my reason of taking care of animals. And when you get to know an animal and they really show who they are, as a dog, they have such a great personality. With all my dogs, I look at them and I'm like, I can't believe someone didn't want you. Because they have such great personalities and they're so loving and they give back, All they want you to do is feed them and give them attention, that they're your, that you are their world, you know what I mean? That's it. There's no other, there's no, oh, I'm gonna go out to rent a movie or see a movie or do this or do that. It's like, no, their whole world is you. So I try and give that back to them. I'd like to, they're my world too, And with Buddy, I feel bad that he was kind of out there and no one's taking care of him. I did my part, try to help him out, but it's been so long that he's out there. It's like, well, no one's gonna get him, so I just take it upon myself to do what I can do. There's been a few dogs I've actually seen out here that I wanted to take care of, but I know I just couldn't. But they've been picked up by people or owners. They've been pretty dogs. There's this pet bull. She was bit all over her face, and I was like, oh my God, And she had just had babies. I was like, what's going on with this dog? But she was picked up by these neighbors, and a lot of these neighbors are scumbags, They don't take care of their dogs. And there was a boxer I had saw. I was starving, and I had fed him so much. And the next day I went outside and he was here, and then I came back later on and he was gone. So again, I'm pretty sure someone picked him up. Pretty dog. She looked like a lion. And I've seen packs of dogs around here, but just here and there. But and my whole thing is, people take care of dogs. If you can't take care of a dog, don't get it in the first place, and don't give up on a dog. That's like the worst thing. When I see someone giving up on a dog, it's like, wow, you're just giving away somebody that can't care for themselves, and all kinds of shit. You're just like, okay, I don't want them anymore here, and they can't do anything about it. That's the thing. It's like, so yeah, if you and your girlfriend or whoever, you get into a fight, you can still live your life. A dog, it's like they're helpless. They can't do anything. They can't get their own food. They can't. They have to just kind of wander. So, I try and care for someone that can't care for themselves. So, not that I'm some high and mighty, but that's how I look at it. I try and do the best that I can for my dogs and for any dog. Even cats, even though I'm allergic to them. But I hope, if you're thinking about getting a dog, I hope you do, and I hope you take care of it and help them out, because you're going to be that best thing in that dog's life. That dog will give you back so much, they really will.